I am Dr. J. Rangamani, Professor of Ahmed Business School, Ahmed University. Today we are going to discuss about classification of cargoes and different types of ships. Here we go. Basically, the entire maritime business is divided into two categories. As you can see on the board, the liner and tram shipping. The liner shipping business deals with the cargo carriage with regard to one point to another point. Typically, the cargoes are taken from one port to another port in the containers. So, when the cargoes are taken through containers, we use the word liner. Liner has got three important aspects. Number one, we have got a fixed route. Number two, we have got a fixed schedule. Number three, we have got a fixed tariff. On the other hand, the tram shipping business deals with the carriage of cargo from one point to another point, from one port to another port with regard to the bulk carriage. Typically, cargoes which are dry in nature called as dry bulk cargoes, cargoes which are liquid in nature, cargoes which are gas in nature are carried through tram shipping business. There are three important points as that of liner shipping business with regard to tram shipping business. Number one, there is no fixed route. Number two, there is no fixed schedule. Number three, there is no fixed tariff. So these three points are really predominant with regard to tram shipping business. Next, we go to the third slide. Now we are going to talk about the different types of cargoes which are carried through the ships. Number one, we have got the raw materials that are taken through ships, and we have got semi-finished goods that are taken through ships, and we have got finished goods that are taken through ships. Typically, these three different classification of cargoes are taken through ships. Coming next would be the actual classification of cargoes. The first classification of cargoes would go for the bulk transportation of cargoes. Typically, when the cargoes are taken in bulk manner, we have got this type of cargoes. Second category of cargoes would be the liner cargoes, the cargoes which are taken through containers, the cargoes which are driven in and driven out of the ship, they all come under liner category. The third type of ships would be the break bulk ships, and typically break bulk ships would carry break bulk cargoes. Cargoes which are considered to be general cargoes are taken through break bulk ships. The fourth category of cargoes would be ODC cargoes, over dimensional cargoes. The cargoes which cannot fit into the container, the cargoes which cannot be taken through the bulk manner can be carried through special type of ships, and those cargoes are called as over dimensional cargoes. Here we go to the next slide. Now, dry bulk cargoes are categorized into two types. Number one, the cargoes which are typically taken through dry bulk vessels, we call that as dry bulk cargoes. The cargoes which are taken through tankers, which are taken through the gas carriers will come under the category called bulk cargoes. Here we go to the next slide. There are different varieties of wet cargoes. The wet cargoes will come under the category which is considered to be liquid in nature. For example, the crude oil, the petroleum products, edible oil, all these cargoes will come under wet category of cargoes. Followed by that would be the cargoes which are gas in nature, and those cargoes will come under the gas cargo types. Now, liner cargoes are categorized into two types. Number one, container cargoes, the cargoes which are of very high value are typically taken through containers. And the second category of liner cargoes would be the ro-ro cargoes, the cargoes which are taken through the ships wherein the cargoes can be driven in and driven out of the ships. They are called as ro-ro cargoes. Here we go to the next slide. Container cargoes. Container cargoes typically carry the cargoes which are considered to be really high value. That's the reason it is called as high valued cargoes that are transported through containers. You can see the containers which consists of the pallets just stuffed into the container. The ro-ro cargoes, cars, trucks and vehicles are driven in and driven out of the ship. As you can see on the picture, the cars are taken into the ship, typically in the case of loading of cars into the ships. Next one is the break bulk cargoes. Typically when we carry the cargo in the broken manner, it is called as break bulk cargoes. And the cargoes which cannot be taken through containers are typically taken through the break bulk ships, also known as general cargo ships. As you can see on the board, the bagged cargoes, the drums, the steel products, sugar, rice, tapioca, soya beans, all these cargoes are taken in the bagged manner and they are called as break bulk cargoes. The next one is the ODC cargoes, cargoes which are taken through the ships which cannot be taken through other modes of ships. They are classified as ODC cargoes. As you can see on the board, ODC stands for over dimensional cargo. The over dimensional cargo can sometimes be called as project cargoes. As you can see on the picture, you see a very big drum that is taken through the ship. That cargo can be called as ODC, over dimensional cargo. And in the next slide also, you can see a big boiler which is being transported on the truck. And the next ship, in the next slide, you can see the ship which carries an oil rig, as that of this picture also. Next slide, the different types of ships. As that of the cargoes, the ships are also classified as that of bulk cargo ships, liner cargo ships, general cargo ships and project cargo ships. So as that of the cargo, the ships are also classified in the same manner. With regard to the dry bulk ships, as you can see on the board, every dry bulk ship will have an hatch and the cargoes are typically stored inside the ship and taken out of the ship, delivered to the port side, and the type of the ship is called as dry bulk ship or dry bulk vessels. As you can see on the board, the next slide points to the tanker vessels. The picture points to the crude oil which is being carried in the tanker vessels. The third category of cargoes would be gas carriers. The gas carriers will have a unique appearance in nature, and the unique appearance will make the ship very much unique in carrying the gas cargo because it requires more space to carry the cargo. The next category of ships which is classified would be the container vessels. As you can see on the board, the ship carries so many containers. As I specified earlier, the cargoes which are of very high value are typically taken through the ships, and the ships can be called as container ships. And container ships will accommodate the cargoes which are of very high value. Coming next would be the ro-ro ships. As you can see on the picture, the cargo is typically taken into the ship or driven into the ship. Instead of loading the cargo by using the gantry cranes, typically the cargoes are driven in and driven out of the ship by using a ramp that goes inside the ship. Next one is the project cargo ships. The cargoes which cannot fit into any other type of ships requires a special type of ship called as project cargo ship. And the picture that you see on the board would be the type of ship which is called as ODC ship or project cargo ship. The next picture also points to type of cargo which is used in oil rigs and the ship that is called as project cargo ship. Apart from carrying cargoes, the different types of ships which we normally use would be used for carrying people also, carrying persons. As you can see on the board, ships which carry persons can be classified as passenger ship or ferries, which can be taken to which can take people to a short distance, and hovercraft and hydrofoil. Passenger ship will have a very unique appearance. because it can accommodate people from the lower deck till the upper deck of the ship, and the safety and stability of the ship is very much required with regard to passenger ships. So as discussed earlier, the cargoes which are carried from one point to another point, that is really predominant, and the type of cargo that we normally carry from one port to another port, it requires the special type of documentation also. When we take the cargo which are carried through containers, the cargoes which are taken through the dry bulk manner or wet bulk manner, the type of documentation would be completely different. When the cargoes are taken through liner mode, it specified earlier, it has got a fixed route. It means the ship will start from port A and the cargoes will be delivered to port B in a very scheduled manner. It can be very easily identified when the ship is going to come to port A, when the ship is going to go to port B. So that is really identifiable with regard to liner ships, and that is specified as the liner cargo, and the ship which carries the liner cargo would be called as liner ships. And on the other hand, the tram cargoes, wherever the cargoes are available, the ships will be taken to that place. And for example, the iron ore, which is considered to be a dry bulk cargo, wherever the cargo is available, the ship is taken to that place. So the ship will not have a fixed route, the ship will not have a fixed schedule, and the ship will not have a fixed tariff. It means the ship owner and the ship charterer will discuss with each other with regard to fixing the ship for a specific type of cargo. And they will go for the negotiation and come to a conclusion that the ship can be fixed for a particular charterer. And there are different types of chartering procedures available with regard to tram cargo carriage. One of the most important type would be time chartering. The ship which carries the cargoes on time chartering mode. For example, the charterer may hire the ship for a week's time, for a month's time, for 2 years. So if the ship is hired on time basis, typically time chartering will come into action. The ship can also be hired through the voyage chartering. So voyage chartering would become the second type of chartering mode. And the second type of chartering mode is also very much predominant. The only thing is the owner will have more control over the ship as compared to the time chartering. When the ship is taken through time chartering mode, the charterer will have more control over the ship rather than the owner. Even though time charterer will be reporting to the owner as and when necessary, but the control over the ship the time charterer will have to the maximum extent as that of the voyage chartering. The third category of chartering, which is less predominant, that is called as bareboat cum demise chartering. So the bareboat cum demise chartering mode is the third type of chartering mode, wherein the ship is hired for a longer period of time, and this is very rarely used in the practical scenario. Apart from that, when it comes to the port operations, we require unique equipment on the port side for loading and discharging of cargoes with regard to the types of ships that are typically used. And when the containers are to be loaded and discharged onto the ship, we use a particular type of crane called as gantry crane. And depending on the facility available in a particular port, the number of gantry cranes will vary. When loading the container into the ship or discharging the container from the ship, the most important thing that is followed would be the way in which the containers are stowed into the ship. The stowage plan is typically prepared, and then based on the stowage plan, the containers are stacked into the ship. Similarly, when the containers are removed from the ship, we have got the plan to deliver the container one after the other. And whenever the containers are taken out of the ship, it is typically kept onto a truck nearer to the gantry crane, and then it will be delivered to the person who is actually importing the cargo through the container. Sometimes if the person who is importing the cargo could not able to report on time, then the container will be taken to the container yard. And even after that, If the importer, if the client could not able to climb the container, then it will be taken to the nearby place, nearby hinterland place, or sometimes be taken to the inland container depot or container freight station. And there the container will be remaining for a specified number of time and depending on the rules and regulations, and thereafter it will be taken for auction. And when it comes to the dry bulk cargo, the dry bulk cargo requires special type of equipment to load the cargo and discharge the cargo. One of the most important type of equipment that is used with regard to dry bulk cargo would be the conveyor belt. The conveyor belt can be used to load the cargo and discharge the cargo depending on the rate of loading and rate of discharging. Apart from the conveyor belt, we do have a special type of cranes which are used to load and discharge the cargo. One of the most important type of crane that is used would be the orange peel off crane. The orange peel off crane would be used to grab the cargo from the port side and grab the cargo from the ship side also. Apart from that, when it comes to loading of cargo and discharging of cargo with respect to crude oil, we require a special type of pumps which are used to pump the cargo inside the tankers and pump out the cargo. The pumps will be available on both the ship as well as the pumps will be available on the port side. When it comes to the cargoes which are transported through the tankers, especially when it comes to clean products like petroleum products, we require special type of equipments which are used to load and discharge the cargo. Apart from this, the people who are actually involved in handling of cargoes, when it comes to liner cargo, that is the cargo which is taken through containers, we require people like freight forwarders. And typically there are three categories of people. One of the most important type would be the freight forwarders. So freight forwarder will act like the bridge between the client's exporter importer and the liner company. So freight forwarder will actually assist the exporter importer in getting the cargo and taking the cargo to the liner company. So the freight forwarder can be called as the middleman. Apart from that, when there is an import cargo, freight forwarder will give a notification to the importer and thereby importer will be alerted with regard to the incoming cargo. When it comes to the NVOCC, non-vessel operating common carrier, the cargoes are obtained from the exporter and handed over to the importer, handed over to the shipping line. The NVOCCs can sometimes be called as shipless ship line. The third category of people which are considered to be really important would be MTOs, multimodal transport operators. The multimodal transport operators, they are involved in the transporting of cargoes from one place to another place with regard to assisting the exporter importer and the liner companies. When it comes to the tramp operation, the cargoes which are taken through the bulk manner, we have got middleman, we have got a person called charterer. The charterer will be hiring the ship from the ship owner. And in the process of hiring the ship from the ship owner or in the process of identifying the ship charterer by the ship owner, we require somebody in between. That person happens to be the ship broker. So ship broker will assist the ship charterer as well as the ship owner. Ship broker will act like a mediator between the ship charterer and the ship owner. For example, when the charterer is located in Chennai and the owner is located in Singapore, then there will be a broker on the charterer's side in Chennai, there will be a broker on the owner's side in Singapore. So the ship broker on the charterer's side will help the charterer on the Chennai side, and the ship broker on the Singapore side will help the ship owner. Thereby they create a link between the ship charterer and the ship owner. Apart from that, the documentation type that is typically used in our shipping business, the INCO terms, which are considered to be the contractual terms between the seller and the buyer. So INCO terms are the international commercial terms which are revised every 10 years. So the last revision was done in the year 2010. The next revision would be done in 2020. So from January 1st, 2020, we will have a new set of Incoterms. And the Incoterms will tell us the contractual terms between the seller and buyer. Incoterms mainly deal with the responsibility and liability and the transportation cost management. When it comes to the transportation cost, who is going to bear the cost? Either the seller or the buyer should bear the transportation cost. That is identified or that is fixed by mutual consultation between the seller and the buyer. At the same time, the responsibility and the liability of carrying the cargo from the seller's premises to the buyer's premises. So who is going to bear the liability and responsibility? That is also clearly specified in Incoterms. So there are various Incoterms. All Incoterms will have only three letters. To give an example, we have got an Incoterm called FOB, free on board. So when it comes to free on board, suppose when the cargo is available in the exporter's premises, the cargo will be packed and then loaded into the container, and then the container is loaded into the ship. The ship goes to the nearby port, and then the truck goes to the nearby port, and from the truck the cargo was taken out and kept onto the ship, and then the ship goes to the destination point, and the destination point typically the container is removed from the ship and taken through the truck or through the railway mode and delivered to the customer. Now the point is, the cargo is taken from the customer's premises or the seller's premises till the port side. Now, say for example, if the cargo is available in Chennai, and in Chennai if cargo is available in a particular point, and from the point wherein the seller is doing business, the cargo is taken to Chennai port, and the cargo is taken to Chennai port through the truck, and the truck goes to the wharf, and till that point the Incoterm FOB can be used, and the container is removed from the truck and kept onto the ship. So till the container is kept onto the ship, the seller is responsible for paying the transportation cost and also accepting the responsibility. After that, the buyer will take the responsibility and the buyer will pay the transportation cost. So Incoterms are really convenient for both the seller and the buyer. To repeat that, it is a contractual term between seller and buyer. Now, coming to the next classification of cargoes and ships, we discussed about different classification of cargoes and ships. Finally, we are going to discuss about the types of ships which are used when the lanes are to be kept open. Here we go. As you can see on the slide, we have got four categories of the ships which will keep the lanes open. For example, tugs, dredgers, icebreakers and research ships. So these four ships are really predominant and very much useful in order to keep the lanes open. These ships will not be used to carry cargo, but these ships will assist the other ships to move the cargo from one port to another port. Whenever the ship enters into a port, the ship has to get the guidance from the tugboats. And typically whenever the ship has to be berthed, we require tugboats. There are two types of tugboats. One is called as pull tugboat, another one is push tugboat. Typically pull tugboat will pull the ship and push tugboat will push the ship. And these two tugs are effectively used in order to take the ship to the appropriate berth, and mooring will be done. As you can see on the board, we have got a tugboat. So the tugboat can be a push tug or a pull tug. The tugboat has got a very powerful engine wherein it can push or pull the tug, pull the ship. With regard to the next slide, we have got a dredger. Dredgers are typically used to keep the lanes open. As and when we have got the high tide, the entire lane will be closed by the sands. In order to dredge the sand out of the place, we require a dredger. So dredger will make the lanes open, and in order to have an appropriate depth and draft, the dredgers are used. There are other kinds of ships which can be called as icebreakers. When the ships are taken to the polar side, wherein we have got a lot of ice on the sea, then we need icebreakers. So icebreaker will break the ice and it will pave way for other ships to follow. The research ships, which are considered to be very much important, time and time again, the research ships are used to do continuous research with regard to the marine. In order to summarize whatever we discussed, the cargoes are taken through the ships, and there are ways to take the cargoes through the ships, and we cannot take the cargo just like that. We require appropriate packaging and other precautions to be made with regard to carrying the cargo through the ships. The different classification of ships, different classification of cargoes, both are really predominant. Typically, the cargoes, when they are taken through the bulk manner, the cargoes which are taken through the container mode, the cargoes which are taken through the bags and sacks and drums, the cargoes which are driven out, the cargoes which are taken through the ship which is considered to be the overdimensional cargo. So these are all the classifications of cargoes, and the classifications of ships will also be based on the classifications of cargoes. Like, we have got dry bulk cargo ship, which can also be called as bulkers. We have got wet bulk cargo ships, which can also be called as tankers. And we have got the ships which are capable of carrying the containers. They are called as container ships and ro-ro ships. And we have got the ships which will carry break bulk cargoes. They are called as general cargo ships. And we have got ships which can carry the overdimensional cargoes. They are called as the project cargo ships. So these are all the classifications of the ships when it comes to the carriage of cargoes. And there are ships which are available in the specialized manner to carry the people from one point to another point. And there are ships which will keep the lanes open. Thank you very much.